In 1897, Europeans who dressed up themselves in the clothing of Jews, remember, they are Europeans who are parading as Jews, okay? They're called European Jews, but they're essentially Europeans. Judaism is only a camouflage. These people established the Zionist movement.
The Zionist movement was a European movement. I mean, those people spoke the same language. They came from the same culture. They were more sophisticated. They knew how to move and to which people to speak and how to negotiate with the British elite and other elites in the world.
Hungarian-born Theodor Herzl is the founder of political Zionism. The solution he put forward in 1896 in a radical book entitled The Jewish State was for the Jews to have their own territory, a territory in which they would no longer be the minority and could run their own affairs. A small community of Jews, numbering around 25,000, were already present in Palestine at this time. For centuries, they had lived alongside the majority Arab population peacefully under the religiously tolerant Ottoman regime. But the sophisticated European newcomers, soon to be known as Zionists, had little in common with the indigenous people of Palestine, not least their fellow Jews.
Zionism was a nation-state ideology which aimed at the foundation of an independent Jewish state. The reason for this depended on the colonialist and social Darwinist theories which dominated 19th century Europe. According to these theories, the industrialized nations of the West had the right to colonize less developed nations. This was envisioned as a natural result of the concept of the struggle for survival between nations predicted by Darwinism. The Jews who put forward the idea of Zionism approved of this 19th century European era and constructed their own ideologies in the light of it.
This is a European creation. It didn't come out of the world of Islam, oh no.
Judaism, a divine religion, has become a vehicle for Zionism, a worldly ideology. The problem is not Judaism and the Jews, but rather Zionism and the Zionists. The relationship between Zionism and Judaism has never been a realistic one. Those who put forward the ideology of Zionism were people who had nothing to do with religion. Max Nordau, the second important movement leader after Herzl, was a confirmed atheist.
Centuries before this, they had struck at Europe. And over a period of almost 300 to 400 years, they had transformed Europe from a civilization based on faith in Christianity to a new, essentially godless civilization. Having done that, they are now ready to strike when they create the Zionist movement.
Zionist Jews actually had a design on the land of Palestine, the idea of creating a homeland for Jews in the land of Palestine. And this is really the beginning of the conflict.
We have been living there hundreds of years together in harmony and peace, total harmony with the population, the indigenous Palestinian population, which was a mixture mainly of Muslims. The Jewish was definitely a small minority, but mainly it was Muslims and Christians who were there. Zionists, being that they wanted to sell their new concept, which around 100 years ago, they came to the Jewish people and they said, hey, you're hoping for the days of the Messiah. We're ushering this in. We're going to take you back to the land. Just they left out God out of this equation. They took this physical concept, and they, like I say, it's a conflict. If you study this and understand this, you understand how it is totally contradictory to what Judaism is.
Let's define terms. What is a Jew? If you look back in your Old Testament, your Bible, there were 12 Hebrew tribes. The 10 northern tribes were called the House of Israel. The 2 southern tribes were called Benjamin and Judah. More properly pronounced, Judah. Because we didn't get the harder sound to the J until about 200 years ago. So this is what I would call real Jews. People from the tribe of Judah. And when we start talking about the New World Order, we are not talking about these people at all. We're talking about these Khazar warriors that only pretended to embrace Judaism. And so today, we find that about 92% of the people who claim to be Jews really aren't. They don't have a drop of Semitic blood in their veins. They are Khazar warriors with a new bent on life and a goal to conquer.
The stage was now set. The countdown has begun for the Jews to strike. After waiting for almost 2,000 years, they are now ready to strike to achieve their long-held objective of bringing back the Golden Age.